Hello students, I am Dr. Gajendra Purohit. I upload videos for Engineering Mathematics B.Sc on my YouTube channel. If you are preparing for any competitive exam where higher mathematics is asked, my channel is very helpful for you. On iTab, watch previous videos on linear algebra, real analysis, modern ODE, PDE, numerical analysis, integral calculus and vector calculus through the I button. And you'll also find the link in the description box of these videos. Today I am going to tell you about the formation of differential equations. Although I have already uploaded a good amount of content on differential equations, I am again uploading a bit updated content this time. This is differential equation 2.0 where I will provide you with the content which I previously shared. But now I will present a better content with a few updates and improvements. Today we will learn about the formation of differential equation. And so in this lecture I will explain how do we form differential equations. So if there is any curve given, and if we need to form its differential equation of that curve, we need to see how many constants are given in that curve. The number of constants will be there. Accordingly, we will have to eliminate that constant and we have to take its derivative and then we will have to form its equation, right? Let's take an example. Equation x square plus y square equals a square. This is a circle given here. We know that it has one constant. If I want to form its differential equation, I have to eliminate this a. What do I have to do here? I have to eliminate it, right? So I will differentiate this once. We know the differentiation of this is 2x plus 2y. dy by dx is equal to 0. See, this constant is eliminated. Now, the differential equation that we will get is, we will keep this dy by dx and divide by y. So x divided by y will be the differential equation. Now you will say, sir, how do we know this is the differential equation? Students, when you solve this again, you'll get this answer, right? Now you'll say, sir, how do you solve this? We can solve this by using the variable separable method. I will explain this method to you later. You can see on solving we get y here, right? And x dx will go to that side, here x dx, and when you'll integrate this again, we will get c here, and we know its integration will be y square by 2. Its integration will be x square by 2 is equal to c. 2 will go there. So we will get the equation x square plus y square is equal to 2c, and we can assume 2c as a square here, and we will get the same equation, right? So what is the formation of a differential equation? It is taking a curve, finding the constant and eliminating that constant and then creating an equation in the derivative form. This is known as the formation of a differential equation and you just need to see how many constants are there and how you can eliminate those constants. So you have to check that here. Now this step has a working rule that whenever we form a differential equation here, we have to first write the equation of the family of curves. Sometimes the question is given in the form of a theory such as, find the equation of a circle whose center lies on the x-axis and it passes through the origin, right? Or where the center of the curve is on the y-axis and it passes through the origin, or it's a parabola type question, right? Hence first, whatever question is given here, first we need to write it in the form of an equation and then we will have to differentiate it. And on eliminating the constants from there, the equation that we get will be the differential equation of this. Now, I will take some examples and I will try to explain some concepts using those examples. First example, it is given y is equal to e to the power mx and we are asked to find the differential equation for this. We have m as a constant, which means we need to eliminate it. So what will we do? We will differentiate this here. We will find the derivative of dy by dx, right? Now we will get dy by dx is equal to m e to the power mx, right? Now because here we need to eliminate m, so what we will do here? We will replace this e to the power mx with y. Therefore, we will get dy by dx here, right? Is equal to, we will get my here. And we get this m which has not been eliminated yet because m is given here. Since the constant is 1, you might say differentiate it one more time. No, we will not do that. We are getting m once, so we will get a first order equation and we can't form a second order equation. Now we have to eliminate m, how we will do it. In this case, what can we do? Here we can take the log on both sides. So we will get log y because when we will remove e, we will take the log, clear? Now, if we find out the value of m from this, then what we will get? It will become log y upon x, where it is m. Put this value there. Then we will get dy by dx is equal to here it will be y, right? And students, what is the value of m in this? It will be log y upon x. You can simplify this. Students, here we will get dy by dx minus y log y, right? What we will get here? Y log y upon x is equal to 0. So, this will be its differential equation. In this way, we can form a differential equation. Now, I will take another example here, so that you can understand it better. Let's discuss about one more question given. Find the differential equation of this curve y is equal to a cos mx plus b for its integral and where a and b are the arbitrary constants. So, you can see that there are two constants. A, B, and you might say M is also a constant here. We will check if we can eliminate this constant up to the second order. If yes, that will be okay, or else we might have to do it up to the third order here. We will have to check how we will do it. When we have a question given here, y is equal to this is given, a cos. Mx plus here b, right? If we will differentiate this, we will get dy by dx. And we know that the differentiation, of course, is minus sine, right? Hence, here we will get sine. Mx plus b, and this m from mx will move to this place. Now, what do we do here? We will take one more derivative because we will do till second order ones. D2y by dx square, again, we will differentiate this, sine will be cos. But since we will write m again here, this will be m square. Cos mx plus b clear. And we know that value of cos mx plus b. A is y, right, students? And here it will be d2y upon dx square is equal to. Here it will be minus m square. And the value of a cos mx is y. We will get this here, and on solving it will be d2y by dx square plus m square y is equal to 0. This will be our differential equation because in the question a and b are given as constants. We are not given any information about m. Therefore, in this way, we will solve it here. And now suppose if this type of question is given in your exam, then how will you solve it? You have to find the differential equation of all circles which passes through the origin and whose centers are on the x-axis. Here you are asked to find all the equations of circles whose center is on the x-axis. Let's assume that the center of the circle here is given a and 0. And this is passing through the origin. Now you have to find the equation of this type of circle, right? We know that what is the equation of any given circle. Here, since it passes through a 0, so it will be x minus a whole square plus y minus 0 whole square. We know that radius of this circle is also a. What do we get? This is the equation of the circle. This is the center and here this is the radius, right? Now let's simplify this a bit. So this will be x square minus 2ax plus a square plus y square is equal to a square. This a square and a square will cancel out. So x square minus 2ax plus y square is equal to 0. We have one constant, that is a. If we have to eliminate only one constant, differentiate it, then we will get 2x minus this, it will be 2a plus this will be 2y dy by dx. Now here we have to eliminate this 2a. What will we do? We will find the value of 2a from here, right? So how we will find the value of 2a from here? If I solve this, we will get the value of 2a. You put this 2ax on the other side. So 2ax is equal to, here we will get x square plus y square. We will get the value of 2a. X square plus y square upon x. Now you can put this value in place of 2a. I will write in different color the equation we will get here. It will be 2x minus the value of 2a, that is x square here, plus y square upon x plus 2y dy by dx is equal to 0. This is the equation we get. Now you can take the LCM as x. Take the LCM as x. This will be 2x square minus x square minus y square. Plus it will be 2y dy by dx, right? You can see x square cancels out with x square. It will be 2y dy by dx. And plus here we will get this x square minus y square upon x is equal to 0. You can divide this 2y. Then it can be written as dy by dx plus x square minus y square upon 2xy is equal to 0. So this is the differential equation we will get. And in this way, we solve this type of equations, clear. Now students, how we will solve this? In this question, we have a differential equation given as y equals c into x minus c whole square. So we will differentiate this. This will be dy by dx is equal to c. And this 2 will come here into x minus c. And now we will divide both of these terms. When we will divide this, what I will do is I will write dy by dx above. And divided by y is equal to. I will also write this in the same way. This will become 2c into x minus c. This value will come here. Divided by c into x minus c, we will get this in the denominator and it will be whole square. You can cancel this c and x minus c. Then we will get the value here. We will get 1 upon y into dy by dx here. Is equal to, we will get this as 2 divided by x minus c, right? What we will do here, we will find the value of c, clear? Now we have this. What I will do is I will write this here, y dash upon y is equal to, and it will become 2x minus c. We will simplify this a bit. Now what we will get as x minus c, the value of x minus c we will get as 2y upon y dash will be the result. So here from this, what will be the value of c? X minus 2y upon y dash. Now we got this c and we have to eliminate it. So you can place c here. we will get y is equal to c. Or maybe you can also put it here. It will be better because the whole square is creating a problem. You can place it here. Right. Now let me erase this and put the value in 2c into x minus c. And when I will put this value here, it will be dy by dx is equal to 2. And here I will substitute x minus 2y upon y dash. And when you will substitute it here, then this will be x minus. It will be minus x plus 2y upon y dash, right, students? And this x will cancel out with this x. Now we will get this as dy by dx is equal to here. This will be 4y divided by y dash multiplied by x minus. It will be 2y divided by y dash. And you can see since here this is y dash, right? So we will erase it. It will be better if you write this as y dash here. This is y dash and here also y dash. What we will do is take the LCM of y dash. What will be the LCM of y dash? On taking the LCM, we will get 4y. Upon y dash, and here we have y dash. On taking LCM, we will get x y dash minus 2y upon y dash. This y dash and y dash will become y dash square. Cross multiply it. This will be y dash cube is equal to 4y x y dash minus 2y. So this is what we will get here as its differential equation here, right? In this way, we form the equation. And since we have one constant here, so students, the derivative that we will get will also be of the same order. And you must understand this concept. Now this question is given and you are being asked that for the family of curves containing three arbitrary constants, the order of this differential equation is. If three constants are given in any function, then what will be the order of its differential equation? There are four options given here and you have to tell me the answer in the comment box below. Clear? How many seconds did it take you to solve this? And students, please comment and let me know if you are liking the content or not. I am modifying the content and whatever videos I have uploaded till now, I am re-uploading the content. So that you can understand things better. And you can also watch my differential equation videos from here. The videos I uploaded earlier, my short trick videos that I'm uploading on my new channel, you can watch them here. Please subscribe to my new channel from here and follow me on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching me. Please like, share it and do subscribe to the channel. Let me know the feedback in the comment box. Thank you very much.